Hello, Gundam fans. This is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Grimoire from the Gundam Reconquista and G series. So this is the pirate mobile suit, the Grunt. It's very different. It's really pudgy and round. Has a really different looking head. Yeah, overall, it's definitely unique. It does have some stickers. You got a metallic pink underneath the cameras, pink on the collar, on the sides, for some reason, on the knees, and on the back skirt. I don't know why, because these front pieces are plastic, so they could have just duplicated that over here, but they chose to have one solid piece of plastic. Same thing with the knees. They could have, these front parts of the knees are severed, they could have easily had a light brown piece feed into it, into a hole, and they didn't. So, a lost opportunity there, I think. It's a pretty solid kit, too. I don't know why these are here, these fins. They're kind of just there for no reason. I like the backpack, the little antenna here. It's very small. Yeah, overall, it's a very... it's unique, and it actually works... it holds together really well. So, the design is, pretty good. Well, I say the design is pretty good, but I wish they had to lift these fins off because the arms are limited because of that. You have to force the arms out to get them forward like that, and they go that far out. That's it. The head is also limited because of the collar. You have a teeny bit of forward and back and up and down, and it will rotate, but not a problem, that's good. The arms will also rotate below the shoulder. Oops, they're hinged at the elbow. This is actually plastic. Just a little plastic connector. The polycap in there gives it a little bit of a bend. And then you have a wrist hinge, which is nice, and a ball joint. A ball joint chest, so it doesn't actually go up and down and side to side. And then a swivel waist, which I guess you want to have that middle piece separate. I don't know. And you have ball joint front skirts that can separate. Hinge. Yeah, these are the side skirts way back here. Kind of weird. The legs can do the jiggy-jig-jig. And they'll go forward. A little back. Out. They do rotate at the hip, but you have to kind of have them out. Because if you have them too close, they start hitting the waist. Knee is one joint. Same kind of hinge as the elbow. Then you have a hinge at the ankle, ball joint ankle armor at the side, and a ball joint foot with a little bit of a swivel. Which is weird, because this one, I can get out no problem. I don't know why, but I can't get this one out. I don't know what I'm doing wrong with the ankle armor. It wants to stick. And so if I move the ankle too far out to the side, it pops this part off. Kind of weird. But, yeah, even though it's weirdly articulated in some areas, it actually does have... you can get some pretty good poses. So, articulation is... it's okay. Now, it does have a melee weapon, which is actually stored in the back. Right here. There's a little slit all the way through the inside of the back skirt. So it actually stores in there. It's a little tricky to get out. Gonna have to push it from the one side and then pull it like that. Very detailed little knife. Kind of hard to see the weight, but it is very detailed for a knife. And the way they show it on the picture, you don't have to have it like up, but in the picture they show it like this. And it works pretty well. And you also have the, I guess it's a beam rifle, a little green sticker for the scope, which has a cut right here, which is a good idea because you can actually fit the hand into it. And so it gives the illusion that it's got its finger wrapped around the trigger, but there's the hole there. Oops. So you got that. Looks pretty good. A little bit of black just to go with the backpack. And then you have this. It's another kind of like a melee weapon. It's like a beam... I don't know what you want to call it. I call it a beam ribbon, pretty much. Because I think, I'm assuming, it's fed through a spool in here, and then it just pops out here. So if part of it gets taken off, you can just shoot some more out. And it is bendy enough, so you can kind of have it conform to different poses, although it does. It feels like it's going to snap if you go too far. Although you're gonna get two, so that's good. And then you have the shield, which is roundish, kind of like the body. You got a swivel here. And there's a little peg, which kind of conforms to a hole in the arm. Is that a super... Oops. It's not a super solid connection, but it will stay. And then you also have another hand. You have another holding hand. So if you want to have the knife in this hand and the beam rifle in this hand, you can do it. So those are the accessories. Not a lot, but it's got some different stuff. We'll see in other mobile suits later on. But this is the first time we're seeing them. And they're pretty neat. I don't know why. I really like this knife. And I really like the fact that it just goes right in there for storage. So accessories are pretty good. And now let's compare this guy to the G-Selfie. Since they are actually showing a lot together, side by side in the show. And you can see he's a little short, and dumpy, and stumpy, and chubby. He's like the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. There's a custom. And how about another grunt-esque mobile suit? The cardigan. Yeah, still a little bit shorter, and yeah, this guy's just really different. I do like it for that fact, that it is so out there. Oh, and I almost forgot. These actually move. Why? Why not? So that is the Grimoire. A very different and cool little mole suit. I don't think there's not... I wish they would have adjusted a couple design cues on the thing, like these fins. Maybe made the arms a little better. Seam lines here. A little bit annoying. The rest of it's pretty good. All in all, it's a nice little grunt mobile suit. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.